The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tiger Technician Hour with your host, Basil Chapman. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Basil Chapman.
Hi everyone, Basil Chapman, Tiger Technician's Hour on this 28th day of June, just about to wrap up the week and the month of June. Oh, what a choppy month. All right, so let's look at the numbers. We're looking at the E-mini right now, down up 350 at 2708. The arch formation with a low of 2697.25 on the 29th of May ran up to the June the 13th high of 2796, round number high, peak D in the Chapman wave methodology, plunges down, then rebound, and then comes crashing down in candles that were very big red candles. But wait a minute, look at those big green candles on the left. So it's interesting that in price, going from the low of the 29th of May, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 bars to the upside, 11 days. And then on the right side, you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 today's the 11th. And we are above the 2679. We made a higher low today of 2693.25. Not much, but 4 points higher. That's enough to say that at least so far today, that's higher than that left side. What is this? June the 28th. So it's a month almost to the day. And it's been up and down, 11 days up, 11 days down. This is going to be very interesting. Why? Look at the technicals. How the MACD is fading miserably. Look at the stochastic, way down to 21% level. That's not so good. Unbalanced volumes with the blue line is attempting to rally. The red for strength is weak at about 41%. As it stands right now, this arch formation is going to do a really big and very important test of this candle on the 29th of May. One of the things I mentioned to subscribers is this Chapman Wave Roman candle from Monday. If we took that out and then closed below it, or if we took the upside out and we closed above it, in this case, 2758, round number high on the 25th, if today it had to be within 2 days of the third day, it's already pushing it a little too much. But within 2 days, maybe three, we can close above there, the S&P that is, the futures. That would be very positive. Instead, what we're doing is we're testing at 2706. We're only 7 points above the low of the day. Got to watch this closely. Why? Because tomorrow's Friday, and there's one more day in which to really repair the damage that's done in the weekly chart with a lowercase h that goes to a lowercase m. Now, many of you don't use the futures, so I'm going to quickly change and go right through the numbers. Here we go. The Dow broke the Chapman Wave Roman candle low of 24,084. It broke the 200 period, the orange line, 200 period support at 24,039. To date, went below, it went to 23,997. You can see that you've gone 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 bars up to the 11th of June from the 29th of May low. 25,402, 1,200 points below the 26,616 all-time high. Just like the semiconductors failed to make its test the March high. Just as the S&P failed to take out the January high, this to me is serious stuff. Why? Because we've come down and we've taken out this 24,247 low of May the 29th. We've got under it three out of four sessions. We've gone to a leg D. We tested the 200 period moving average. The MACD is still negative. The stochastic is starting to flatten out at 11%. That is one little positive sign. The unbalanced volume is attempting to rally. So there's a little bit of strength here. We are short the Dow in my opening call subscription, subscribe subscription series. If you look, right there, there was leg D, and I said everything about this said that we should be turning down, and I said we will short the Dow if it hits, can't remember the number anymore, but anyway, it was the very next day, we went short, we switched from the long position to the short position. So the weekly chart shows even more the disparate, the lowercase h with the lowercase m, the disparate technicals where the bounce from the 23,360 low that was made after the 26,616 all-time high just 2 weeks later smashes down. The difference now in the technicals is very weak. The MACD is deflected lower. It's about to test really important support in the dash trend line, and that will be in this week. It'll be 23,890. We tested 100 points above that. Days young, let's see what happens. 120 minute chart, I'm just going to get this out the way. It's not, this one is not the one that's notated like my others. We've got 1 day to go, and we are about the 24,000. I can't see it now because we're so close on it, right there. 24,998 is the 9-period exponential moving average in the monthly chart. We've tested every single month since the February Chapman Wave Roman candle right there. Hit that 23,360 level, try to bounce the next month, and then in right there. In April, came down and broke it. It was the only index to break its left side low of the 9th of February. If there's a close tomorrow at 4 o'clock underneath the 23,350, I want to be a little bit below. If there is a close below 23,950 tomorrow, it's going to suggest to me that we are in at least an intermediate term sell mode. We're already there. It's 5 months since the January high. But more importantly, the weekly is broken down in the lowercase h to lowercase m, suggesting a test of the 23,300s is coming sometime in the next 2 weeks. And if the monthly chart closes below, that MACD is going to close negative. Stochastics at 63%. That'll be a heads up to say, watch out, this is a peak E, and there could be a much more serious decline. And I'm saying to subscribers, we've got to raise cash, be very careful. And I'll have a lot more to say over the weekend. Now, within the context of the S&P, I don't want to run out of time, I want to do these things, haven't got much time. The high of peak D in the Chapman wave, 27.9147 on the 13th of June. We've come down, but we have not even come close to the 26.76 low of, that was, I think, the 29th of May. We're, the low today so far is 26.9199. That's a fair amount above. So that's good. And the up channel support level in the Chapman wave inside track weekly chart is holding okay. It's still got the lowercase h, the lowercase m, and the 9-period moving average is way down at 26.50. We're at 27.03. So it looks to me like there's going to be a dichotomy, a difference between some of the indices kind of breaking down and some of them holding very strong going into the monthly candle of June. I'll be right back and we'll finish up with the all these little these niggardly things, these, what are they called? They are the Qs, the IWM, they'll go to the New York Stock Exchange. We'll be back soon after this break.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank. Bank is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com. The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked, money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Basil, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Hi, everyone. Basil Chapman, Tiger Technicians out. We're back. And what is happening over here? Once in a while. Let me see. There's a big arrow. That's not the arrow I need. All right. So, actually, I'll put up a chart of AKS, which is AK Steel. A question Jim wanted to know about. Wave counts and all that. I'll get to it in a moment. I think it's not looking good at all. In fact, it's looking terrible. I got a chart all of a sudden of Tesla. I was asked about that. Let me just finish up here. You've got the QQQ series trading at 170.25, up 52 cents. Made a leg B to the downside. This has got the arch formation. Says they should. There could be a rally at any point, but the MACD suggests there'll be lower lows to come. The big thing is, how do we close Friday for that weekly candle? This is a different pattern altogether. So far, I had to say yesterday is a chance. I'm going to have to call it a G/C. I'm doing that right now for the weekly. Leg E in the monthly. I am not going to ignore the fact that it's a leg E. If it's recycled, yes, this could be an instant restart. It'd be a spectacular 2018 to 2019. I have a feeling first, before we get any spectacular, we've got very unspectacular to come. So I'll give you the parameters. QQQ is very strong resistance in the 170.150 to 172.80 area. Support, yeah, I'm just going to say, as I've said all along, starting to close in the 167s would be very negative anytime in the next week. Just watch it real closely. IWM. Trading down 32, no strength at all. IWM down 32 cents at 163.07. Let me make this a leg B to the downside. MACD, the moving average convergence divergence daily, is just starting to expand. The stochastic's only at 21%. I think it's going to go to the teens and then the single digits in this particular move down. We remain short from the very right, almost to the tick of the top. I don't know how that's going to work out. So far, it's worked out nicely. I don't know how it's going to work out in the weekly chart, because really, let me just open this up and I'll show you something interesting. Whoops, not that. Open this up here. There's the weekly chart in the middle. You see, because that pullback from peak E at 160.63 on the week of the 26th of January, pull back to 142.50, that's 18 points. That's a 12% correction. What I am looking at here is that you did not take out that initial leg A. low of 134.12. So this says this could, in fact, be a leg F alternate count, because that rally that was made right there at the end of March went to 160.30, failed to make a new high, and then you pulled back and made another peak A, but underneath the previous major high of 160.63, week of the 26th of January, that was the week of the top of the down the S&P. So this could have an alternate count, and I think just, I'm going to put it in. I didn't want to put it in. The MACD is still good. The stochastics are 90%, but I just want to show that there are times where you need to know what the alternative count is. Just be wary, because my daily chart is suggesting very strongly that a test of the 161 to 160 area of the coming couple of weeks is very likely. And if it does that, that will be under the 9-period moving average in the weekly chart. We'll have to see where the MACD and stochastic is. Leg F slash B in the monthly chart still looks great in terms of the pattern, but not in terms of the candle that's formed in June. So there's a lot to be desired right now, although it's still spectacular action. NYA, just someone asked if I could do the NYA. Actually, someone mentioned the XMI. I don't know if I've got it updated. Yeah, this is the pattern that we've been looking at in gold and so many other things, where you go from the lowercase h to the lowercase m, and then you break the low. I'm watching this because today the New York Stock Exchange had up $8 at 12,411, broke under and hasn't closed yet, but it broke underneath the 12,391 low of the 29th of May. This is serious stuff. Peak D in the week, in the monthly chart. I can't ignore all these peaks. Chapman-Wave peaks are important in the count. Just we failed to do the rally that was a viable option. We did take some money off because, I mean, these huge gains that we've made in the three times shorts. I just had to, for money management reasons. We kept the core. In some cases, we kept a huge chunk. We've taken some money off. 28% gain. I mean, you can't sneeze at that. Sneeze? Don't talk about sneeze. The gold is down 4 at 12.51. Leg E, I just see no joke. Every day I look at this and I say, what? Nothing. There's nothing there. Nothing there in the weekly chart yet. My guess is that when gold eventually makes a rally, it'll probably take out 4 or 5 or even 6 weeks of sideways action. But it's going to be quite a while before it does that. And that arch formation, June candle coming up, one of the ugliest candles we've seen as a full body candle, not the price, but the actual candle itself, just breaking as we speak. It's breaking key support in the uptrend. I haven't just spoken about silver for a couple of days because it's also very ugly. This doesn't look good. Platinum, I think, was doing the same thing. That's even uglier. High grade copper. We're in a bear phase in many of these areas. Oh, copper looks just terrible. Now let's go to the TLT. It should be rallying, but in fact, it's down 18 cents. Stuck at the 200 period moving average resistance in the weekly chart. Wow, I tell you something. This is one heck of a market. We haven't seen a market like this in ages. Leadership, what happened to the XLF? So TLT is in the higher range at 121.93 to the upside now. I suspect if it breaks into the 121.93, if it goes to 122.90 to 123.35-ish, those bond yields are going to come down a little more, as we spoke about yesterday, or within a trading band. But that's gonna say market is very vulnerable. I'm missing anything? No, I've done everything. Oh, crude oil. Of course, I'm missing crude oil. Crude oil is now up 70 cents, extending that leg B, extending the leg E in the weekly, extending the leg D in the monthly. Very good action. Can't deny it. As I said yesterday, crude oil looks very good right now. Whoa, I covered a lot. Now, quick question. Bob wants to know about the WMT, Walmart. You know, I'm looking at Walmart. I haven't updated it. Let me see where this all fits. So there's a pattern, left side, right side, price, time match. It's kind of struggling here. It's at 86.15. What was the question, if I can find it? Is Walmart about to become a long? Basil, as I look at the daily chart for Walmart, I notice that it has formed a peak A as of 10:39 a.m. Peak A. Oh, that's a new one. Yeah, this is a new leg A, probably a peak A. It's actually, I'm calling it an E slash A. Why? Because you see the MACD deflected up. So this is still the same move from that leg D. I'm just going to give it the benefit of the doubt right now. And I'll say, wow, if it is a brand new A, other things have to happen. Stochastic's good, MACD's good, but look, the price is kind of struggling in this trading band. So far, let's just call it E/A, nothing wrong with that. Tops of recent candle, wicks, 8 piercing, the 200, the 200 period moving average, just did it again, so that's become a magnet. But the more importantly, if you look at the monthly chart, the weekly chart, this is a pattern I drew in a little while back. And I do it every once in a while. You remember I did this, look, let me just show you here, just a break for a second, because we're talking chart patterns. Was it IWM? I think it was the IWM that gapped up to ES. Remember I drew the arch formation and I said, there's like a railway track that's turning the corner with parallel lines. I like to make them as parallel as possible right there. I said, if you break the inside of this arch, that's going to be very difficult. There were other reasons. Now let's go to Walmart and I'll explain to you what's going on here. You see in the weekly chart, there's something very similar. Looks like a banana. I'll have to call it a banana pattern. I'll be...
TFNN has put together the finest programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 8 hours a day, starting at 9 a.m., as Larry Pesavento kicks us off with Trade What You See. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day, as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour, following the Tom O'Brien Show. Swim Lessons from TD Ameritrade, Thinkorswim, is now at 11 a.m., followed by Basil Chapman at 12 noon. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN.com, educating investors. Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
The TAS Profile Scanner Plus, developed by John Logan and his team, is a standalone piece of software that can change the way you trade. Let the TAS Profile Scanner work for you by scanning over 5,000 financial instruments such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial to the TAS Profile Scanner Plus right at TFNN.com. And when you sign up, you gain instant access to John Logan's most recent webinar, How Price, Volume, and Time Make Market Profiles So Unique. This hour-long webinar with John Logan will walk you through the most powerful features of the scanner and how you can use it to become a more successful and profitable trader. You pay absolutely nothing for 30 days while you try out this software risk-free. For more information on the TAS Profile Scanner and to get your 30-day free trial today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Thinkorswim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
So looking at Walmart, Bob, this is what I'm going to suggest. You didn't ask for any suggestions. You just gave kind of a statement. The question is it going to be making a longer-term up move? My thinking here, it's down 84 cents at 86.05. WMT is the symbol. I have a cup formation forming in the weekly chart. I like to always be very conservative about this. Remember, I did this with the dollar. The dollar was making that low, and the weekly chart was back in September or so, sometime like that. And then we started a long position. We took profits, did it again, took profits, did it again. And the third time at 90.07 is where it all worked out and has been a fabulous run since. So you have to, this is where I would call, you remember you've taken my course and you understand that there's something I call the restart. The restart means that you do, everything's there, you're doing your homework, you get a signal that says there should be a good move to the upside. So you buy, then you get taken out. It doesn't take out the low of importance. That's the most important thing. Then it does it, you do it three times. So I've seen it do it four, even five times. When that succeeds in breaking out, it is one of the most powerful patterns. So Bob, what I'm going to say to you, I'm just going to throw out the suggestion because I don't know how you're doing this with a stock, options or what, but you're an expert in options. I'm going to suggest to you at 86.04, if there is an 87.50 strike, you could even go out for the 90, but I'm just saying I would rather be kind of not in the money, but close to in the money. So that it's at 86.04 right now. If you can get the 87 strike for July, so for the perfect 720, I don't know when the option expiration is in July. Let me just check the third Friday. You don't even have to do it that way, but let me just double check here. Calendar, June, July. Let's get out of June. July 7/4/21. Oh, man. So this goes to the exactly right to the options expiration in July. And you're absolutely correct. It's acting way better than the S&P and all the other indices. What I'm going to suggest to you is get an out-of-the-money call, but just a little bit out of the money. You can get it in the money. I'm just saying probably the best is not to go too far at a 90, but to go to 87.5, and I would get the July call, expires on the 21st of July, and I would look at this, and I would suggest to you that it'll take about another 3-4 days, but if by Tuesday afternoon, Wednesday of next week, you're looking at Walmart taking out yesterday's high of 87.49. Now, I'd like it a little higher. If it takes that 87.78, 87.82, that area, that's going to be very bullish. It's going to make a magnet of this dashed inside Chapman wave inside wedge target line. And the most important thing about it is that you're having an option. Why do I say that? Because if it goes back to the 9-period moving average of the daily chart at 85.39, it's kind of used up a chunk of this move from the 82s to the 87s. So all of a sudden, it could get stuck in a range. So that I'm looking at it, I'm saying you've got, it's a good eye that you've got right on this stock. It looks to me like it's trying to build a base. I like the fact that you're looking out longer term. I'm also looking at longer term. You can even go August for the money. If it's going to work, July 21st would be the best option to get. Call option, and that's what I'm looking at. And if you're wrong, the way I'm looking at it, if you're wrong, it's probably just going to chop sideways for a while so that at some point you get a good part of your money back. You could have that option as well. Hope that helped you. Next question is AKS. John, want to know about AKS? And I'm afraid of this pattern. I've seen it. Look, I've shown it three times. The sideways pattern that makes these arches that goes to lowercase m. If at 427, if AK Steel, which you know is one of my favorites for the short-term play for bounces and things like that, I'm not touching it. I haven't for a while. I said, no, I think that the tariff, whole thing with the tariff, I want to see the steels make money. And then to heck with them, tariffs, they're going to be on fire just from their own internal strength. I don't see that right now. I don't see it in X. It's a little bit better pattern because it's made a higher level consolidation. It's still not great. I don't see it. The SLX, which is the steel ETF, failing. No, I'm sorry. I'm not into steels. I'm not into any of these cyclicals because I think we're in a bear phase, at least for now. So I hope that helps you, all of you. For those of you asking the question about longs, I'm not looking at longs right now. I just think that we need a bear phase to unfold. Bob wants to know about the Boeing. Yep, let's go to Boeing again. Man, this is going to form the same thing. Nope, Boeing's making a double top. There's a U-shaped pattern, Chapman wave, drop bucket formation. It doesn't have to do it, but believe me, if there's a move in the next 3 weeks, you see Boeing, it's at 315. If it closes on a monthly basis, a weekly basis, under 312, watch out. That monthly is going to point to a 1 to 1 to the downside. I think Boeing's in trouble. Short to intermediate term, said that for a while. Totally wrong, because it went to new high. It was just a brief sojourn up into the 370s, round number 372 high in the day it made on the 7th of June. It made its 374.48 high, peak D in the daily. I think this is, I'm almost sure I'm calling this now peak E. In fact, I'm doing it right now. Peak E in the daily. Did I say daily? I meant weekly. Peak E in the weekly. Okay. Edit right there. Peak E. And I'm going to put a little inverted hat because we've already got the down arrow. That's a confirmation. I think this is in trouble. So I hope that helped you. UTX, which we're still long in my opening call for subscribers, from the 119s, it's at 123.99 right now. It's not looking great, but it's held way better than many of the other cyclicals. We only have a very small portion. I'm waiting to see if I want to add in the next 3 weeks or just stay away. Maybe even get stopped down and a little bit left. We've had some nice gains. We're out mostly, but we're just a little bit left. Next question is, this is a good question. Monthly chart, please show of the Dow. All right, I said I'd start looking at monthly charts. Let's do that right now. So I'm going to open this up nice and big. Here we go. Monthly charts. The Dow. INDU. What's the letter? What's the notation in the Chapman wave? A peak E. I have not put a down arrow, even though it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 months with no new high. It is 5 months that has held the 9-period exponential moving average support. I think that's going to go, but I'm thinking is not doing. The MACD right now is barely positive. It's up 5. There's a little green. It's just, it's so close to 0 and then minus, I'm watching it very, very closely. I'm going to make this bigger. Some of you always like to see these charts a little clearer. There, you see it nice and big. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bars, monthly bars, of which 3 have been quite big red candles. One was a Chapman wave Roman candle. One was a plus sign. That was the doji, long-legged doji, 3 months ago. And now we're about to wrap up within another one and a half sessions of trading. The monthly chart, look at that. Stochastic is down. If stochastic deflects from 63%, not good. So I'm just saying, be aware. One of the reasons why I want to hold the long position, the long short position, that is, we're short, the DOG, is because I think that we've made some kind of a top in the Dow and the S&P that's going to need time. It might not need all that much price. I don't know, but it needs time. I'll be right.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, 2x currency-hedged, leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
For real short-term traders, watch very closely the E-mini trading at 2702 right now. It's acting very poor. It's underneath this 200-period exponential moving average, which says it needs to close above 2705. That's really not the issue. It needs to close above 2709 in the next hour and a half to have a decent close today. If it starts to break and it goes back under 2695, be careful. That's all I can say. All right. Where was I? I was looking at a telephone call. Let me just get that a little softer there. Okay. Next question. So those are parameters to watch in the Dow. So 23,385 would be really important, 14-period exponential moving average to hold if there is a breakdown in the next couple of days. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to say the S&P. Let's just do this in the long term, and you'll see exactly the same thing. A little bit better candle because it's above the 9-period moving average, but if the S&P breaks 2650, in the next week, not good action at all. If it pushes above 2723 by Tuesday, I say, hey, great, counter trend rally. More importantly, what I'm really looking at is that the time taken, the 5 months, has really been in a rectangle formation. It's kind of holding sideways. So watch that closely. Those are the parameters. Here we go. QQQ, look at this. A leg E, still only a leg E. It hasn't made a peak. And that's very, very good action. So I don't want to just miss the cues and say, oh, you know, the NDX 100 trading vehicle, lousy stuff. Look at this. No, it made a new high this month, all-time high. It's way above 161, the 9-period moving average. So this is still very good. The MACD is good. Stochastic's good. It's just on the shorter term, the cues are suggesting that it is already struggling, and the weekly chart is going to be very important. A close below 168 support in the next couple of days would be very, very negative. Let's go on here. So I said I look at the monthlies, because look, the IWM, same thing, as it's even a better looking chart than the monthly chart than the others. It's one of the best. Look, it just broke a huge multi-year, almost 10 years uptrend green inside track Chapman wave resistance line. It's underneath it now, but it did break above it. So this is something to watch. So here's what I'm trying to say, and this is the question that was is kind of implied there. Are we in for a major bear market? I could give you reasons to say yes, there's a good chance that if all the sectors, let's just say not tomorrow, but let's go for one and a half weeks' time, about the 10th session of the new month of July, if in that 10th session the Dow is underneath 23,700, at any point, doesn't matter when, a comparable pullback in the S&P, the Qs are underneath the levels I was looking at, the IWM instead of being in the 162 right now, is instead of being in 165, 167 area, is actually trading in the 159s. I think that could become a much more serious decline. Meantime, back at the ranch, if it's even possible, I don't know what's left now. Yeah, you've got some of the retails that are doing well. They're just sectors that are kind of important, but they are not the key sectors. If there is a, look, CTAS, I'll do this all the time. CTAS, which is Cintas, this is uniforms, overalls, leg E, just like the IWM monthly chart, fabulous. But I said yesterday or the day before, I'm going to make this an alternate count G in the weekly chart, not a C, a G. And that to me makes it very important. I have reasons. I can do it because the stochastic's at 88%, but declining, the unbalanced volumes decline very sharply. Relative strength weekly, you see that red, and then it goes gray, starting to turn down. It's at about 60%. Now it's still good, but it's not great. And the MACD is just so close to turning negative. You only need in Cintas another 3 points down, and that weekly chart will become negative. I consider these to be very important. I showed the chart the other day that in my webinar from 2 weeks, 3 weeks ago, I discussed my Chapman Wave, and my new index. I call it cash. It is made up of Cintas right here, Cintas. It's made up of Amazon, AMZN. Look, pull back around number, almost at the high 1760. The high was 1763.10 on the 21st of June. Pull back to 1660, no big deal, but 100 points, you know, it hasn't done a 100-point decline for quite a few months, and it's testing the 9-period moving average this week, leg E in the monthly. I have to consider that these are areas that we've got to look at. SPY, which of course is the S&P, which I just did, and I don't want to do that again, leg C to the downside, and H is Home Depot. Hey, look at this. Home Depot down 44 cents in leg C. I'm watching this real closely. Those are the four key indicators for me now, at least at this particular phase. So now what about the banks? You always have banks participating in huge rallies in the market. Banks are lousy. The XLF is at 26.47, up 11 cents. Look at this major trend line, the same sort of thing we've been looking at, but now it's a downsloping trend line in a leg D in the weekly chart, arch formation. It's at this point, it's lower than it was in the key left side support. Boy, watch this for tomorrow. And look at this, a peak E in the monthly chart. I have to tell you, I'm trying to put this together. I'm usually very optimistic. But in this particular instance, I'm looking at, look, the semiconductors led the way up and they've led the way down. Even today, they couldn't even get a rally in a leg D up from the one, they're at 101.30. We switched from the long to the short side from opening call subscribers in the 110 area, 112 round number high. This is what I wanted to show you. Look, in the monthly chart, let me open this up nice and big. It made that peak D at 114.55 in March. It's had 3 months, tried to rally. It's at the lower end of this candle right now, almost at the 9-period moving average, is closed once under it briefly after it made its all-time high, ran beautifully up last month. Now it's kind of beautifully down. MACD's about to cross negative. It's up 0.04. I mean, this is real close. And the stochastic's down at 69%. I'm only worried because the charts are saying to me they aren't performing the way they did before. They are now... This is the phase that we've been in just lately for the last week or two, for some indexes. It's more than that, but at least for the IWM and the Qs and the SMHs. Remember, the SMHs, like the Dow and the S&P, did not make all-time highs in this most recent rally. I'm just saying, I have to be very cautious right now. It's just real simple. There's nothing wrong with raising cash. Look at the beautiful positions you can get. If you love the semiconductors, wait, look at Applied Materials. Look at that monthly chart going to a lower low than that one just before the all-time high. Yeah, if you want it, you'll get a real good buy on this, but I would just say, have patience. They've had some spectacular runs to the upside. Just give it time. And you can see even today the market, yes, it's bullish. No, it's bearish. Yes, it's bullish. There's a lot of confusion, and that confusion is evidenced by the VIX index. Look, the VIX index holding in the 18s now. I mean, today it hit 19, just about 19, trading at 18.08. It's making a high-level consolidation. Tomorrow, does the VIX index drop precipitously down to the 15s, or does it kind of hold you for the start of July? I think my fund managers are buying some insurance here. Basil Chapman, we'll be right back. Dow's up 8, S&P's up 4. We'll be right back for the final segment. And there's a phone call. Oh, I got John in Philly. John, I'll be with you as soon as we get back.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step-by-step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Hi, folks. This is Steve Rhodes. Stay tuned for another great hour of The Trader's Edge, heard here at TFNN.com.
All right, let's go quickly to John in Philly. Hi, John, how are you?
Good. Morning, Basil. Thanks for taking the call, sir.
My pleasure.
Basil, first, kudos for your patience and then diligence and action in shorting the Dow right at the high, the SMH, and the IWM. Your skill in your patience and then skill in acting when you see something decisively, I admire that greatly.
Well, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
Basil, my question is this regarding the banks and the XLF, and if you might elaborate upon this at the start of tomorrow's show, I would appreciate that. You've been a market practitioner now for decades, and so you've seen a bunch of things, including, I know, the idea that long-time practitioners have noticed and seen in markets that bull markets in stocks very often go through a topping process and end in which bank stocks peak early.
Correct.
begin to decline. Other groups continue higher, make higher highs, and then all start, and then all join each other into a decline phase.
With the bank stocks
having peaked here in January and declining the way they are, I'd like to ask if you would share today and then tomorrow elaborate more on why this is or is not a classic bull market topping phenomenon.
That is a great question. And second of all, to be able to give you a specific answer would there aren't many people that are able to do that. But what I can do is I can show you what I'm looking for, and I'll do that tomorrow. We'll make tomorrow one of my Friday technical Chapman Wave analysis shows, and I'll do that. And I want to show a couple of things that I haven't shown before. Maybe I'll introduce them, or I have shown them once or twice, rarely. And it has to do with channels, and it has to do with breaking out and what happens in the angle of ascent. So, John, great question. Let's deal with it tomorrow. Have a great day. Thanks for calling.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. So, folks, tomorrow will be a special day. We'll do analysis of all these different contingencies, the things that I look at.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.